Two brothers, two motorcycles, and one breathtaking journey around China. Now, if it sounds like a book or a television series, that's because it is both. The Middle Kingdom Ride chronicles a 2-month, 18,000-kilometer journey of a lifetime. Take a look.
My brother and I are starting this unbelievable journey.
20,000 kilometers, 60 days.
Let's get out of Shanghai, baby!
Not easy riding a motorcycle around China.
Watch out for this yellow bus. Always tight. It's the perfect storm.
No way we're getting through here.
This must be one of the most beautiful places you could take a motorcycle.
Here he goes. He's flying.
100 kilometers of feeling really high, and the next 100 kilometers of just feeling really low.
Oh.
This is a 30-kilometer traffic jam.
No one has ever ridden around China on a motorbike before.
Well, Ryan Pyle is one of those brothers who did ride around China, and he joins us from our Los Angeles studios to talk about that journey. Thanks very much for joining us. I know that you had the idea and then you enlisted your brother. What did you think was going to be the hardest obstacle or obstacles as you planned for this trip?
I think just overcoming the kind of daily doubt that we had about trying to plan such an epic journey. And you know, once we were able to stay positive on a daily basis and just kind of slog through it and grind our way through this amazing 2-month adventure, the next biggest challenge was definitely the weather. And China's a large country. It has many climatic zones, and we faced 40 degrees Celsius heat, and we had minus 15 degrees Celsius hailstorms. So, you know, between those issues, this was not an easy adventure.
And how much were you able to pre-plan for that?
The planning was rough. We had an idea of where we wanted to go. We had an idea of how we wanted to get there. But every day we were hit with either a traffic jam or a rainstorm or something that was going to throw us off our course. And we just had no idea how long this journey would actually take.
All right. How did you find the people on the ground? Did they differ, as they often do in countries, from one part of the country to another?
Well, I live in Shanghai, and the purpose of this journey was very much to show the diversity of the people and the diversity of the country that is China. And the people, differed as much as the landscape. In eastern China, on the border of North Korea, you know, the people are completely different than the people out in western China on the borders of Pakistan. And we had a chance to ride through all of those areas and then also show that diversity in our television series. And that was really the main goal of kind of making this adventure, was to learn about China and then to show what we learned through our television show.
And what most of all did you learn?
That China is a big place. Uh-huh. There's a lot of different people that live there, and that it's and to be honest, it's very empty. You know, China has 1.3 billion people. It's the largest kind of populated country in the world. But, you know, a good third of it is really empty. The whole western bit is very, very quiet. It's great to ride. There's not a lot of traffic. And then when you get in through western Tibet and things like that, you don't see people for days. And it's a real dream of a country to travel around.
And if it's very empty and you don't see people for days, this is a question I was thinking of before you came on. How did you manage to get fuel for the motorbikes?
There were some fuel gaps. We did have to carry fuel with us some days. We also carried camping equipment when we couldn't make it to small guest houses or small truck stops to get kind of decent shelter or decent food.
Did you have stored food with you, or pre-prepared food?
Well, we didn't really have any pre-prepared food. We just had a lot of cookies and soda pop, and that kind of got us through the tougher days. It was an expedition. It was an adventure. We planned it kind of as well as we could have, but there were definitely some gaps in our planning.
Let me ask you, was there at any point where those gaps in planning left you a little fearful or scared?
I think, you know, that happened on a regular basis, at least once a week on our 8-week journey. You know, we had an accident. We didn't know if we could carry on. We had a mechanical breakdown, and we had to ship a motorcycle part into China and then actually have someone bring it to us so that we could repair it. You know, there were days where we thought our trip was over, and those were tough days to get through. But we kind of persevered and believed in the path and believed in our journey.
And Ryan Pyle, I'm betting, though, you would do it all over again.
I absolutely would. And actually, Colin and I did do another journey. We did a similar style journey in India. Last year, we actually finished the production, and we're right now in post-production, and that'll be another television series, which will hopefully be out later this year. So we've now completed two epic motorcycle trips around the two most populated countries in the world.
Well, good luck with that. Thank you very much indeed for joining us from LA.
Thank you very much.